and welcome to Reliable Tech. Today I'm going to show you how you can record your iPhone screen without having iOS 11. As you might know, iOS 11 is coming up with a built-in screen recording feature. However, not every device out there is compatible with iOS 11. So if your device is not compatible with iOS 11 or you just don't want to get iOS 11 as you might not have enough space, this is another way by which you can record your iPhone screen. Plus, you don't need any additional software, and this method will also work if you have iOS 11. So without wasting any more time, let's get to it. So first, before we start, we need few things. A Mac, Lightning USB cable, and of course, an iPhone. So the first step is to connect the Lightning cable. So the USB end to the USB port on your Mac and the other Lightning end on your iPhone. Basically, we are done with the work on the iPhone side. Now on your Mac, open QuickTime Player. You can do that three different ways. First, by asking Siri. Second, by using Spotlight. Or third, by actually going into Applications or Launchpad to open QuickTime Player. After QuickTime Player is open, what you would want to do is go in Files and click on New Movie Recording. The movie recording player will open, and what you want to do is click onto the arrow that's right beside the red recording button. When the pop-up appears, click onto the box which says your iPhone name under the camera section. Once that's done, you're basically ready to record your iPhone screen. Turn on your iPhone, and when you're ready, hit the red dot to start recording. After you're done with your recording, to stop, hit the button with a square in it, which basically means stop. Now you can go in Files and then Save to save your recording, or use the keyboard shortcut Command S to save your file, and then choose a location and a name to save your recording with. However, if you're not satisfied with your recording, you can start another recording and delete this one. All you're going to do is click onto the cross or the red dot on the top left corner and then press Delete. Now you can start a recording again by going in Files and New Movie Recording. That's all for this video. If you have any questions regarding this or other topics, then feel free to leave a comment below or email me directly. You can check the description box for the email. I will be making another video on how to record using the built-in iOS 11 screen recording. So make sure to subscribe today if you have not already done so, so that you don't miss out that video. In addition to that, if you would like to know how to record your Mac screen, then click onto the link that you can see on your screen right now, or you can also check the description box for the link. For the closing, all I want to say is thanks for watching, and if you like the video, then don't forget to leave a thumbs up and subscribe if you have not already done so.